So very good morning to all the children of class 9th D. Maximum students have joined now, so I will be starting. Yesterday we discussed beta. I asked you one question, that what do you know about Maria Sharapova? And you people poured in many suggestions. You gave many facts about Maria. You also told about this gameplay. Wait, let them join. Charvi and Jaspreet, always late. Fine. So many of you were saying she's a, you can say, winner of Olympics. Many medals she has won. Somebody was saying she's a Russian girl. Somebody was saying that she won many achievements at very young age. Yes, right. So, but we do not know Maria Sharapova. Background as a person. So we have read about Santosh Yadav, and she has inspired us that how girls can also be tough. So now we will read and compare Maria with Santosh Yadav also. So first part is done. We are going to start with the second part. Okay. So all of you can see the screen. Maria Sharapova, a Russian girl, Maria Sharapova reached the summit of women's tennis when she was barely 18. As you read about her, see if you can draw comparison between her and Santosh Yadav. So they are asking, as I already told you, we have read part one of reach for the top. So we will be reading about Maria, and we will compare also, comparing similarities, that how similar these two girls are, though they are born and brought up in different circumstances. But yes, your internal motivation is the one thing that is common in the whole world. Fine. So they have given one exercise that you will do on your own, match the following. Fine. Then I will ask you the questions, but not now. This is your homework. Okay. So you have to solve this. And now before beta, they have actually kind of comprehension. They have given some questions. Why was Maria sent to the United States? Why didn't her mother go with her? What are her hobbies? What does she like? What motivates her to keep going? So keep these questions in mind, okay? We are going to read the chapter, and you will be able to find the answers. So there is something disarming about Maria Sharapova, something at odds with her ready smile and glamorous attire. And that something in her lifted her on Monday, 22nd August 2005, to the world number one position in women's tennis. All this happened in almost no time, poised beyond her years. The Siberian born teenager, underline this beta, Siberian born in Siberia. Siberian born teenager took just 4 years as a professional to reach the pinnacle. So now what is the meaning of disarming? Like here, it means likable. Note down the meanings in your book only, beta. Disarming here means likable, at odds with, means in conflict with. In conflict with. Poised. Poised means very arrogant. You know, some people are very elegant the way they carry themselves. So poignant here means very elegant. Then we have pinnacle. Pinnacle is the most successful point of your life, the topmost position of anything. Zenith of success is whom keh dete hain, fine. Pinnacle, the top most success point or successful point, fine, you can say. You should know the meanings to understand this paragraph, fine. So they are trying to say, that we see what people are showing to us. We see Maria Sharapova, okay, great personality, glamorous attire is dress, and always smiling face. But to reach, we just observe what is shown in the picture. Behind the scene, we do not try to see that how that person has reached the designation, that reached that place. So many times in lives, you these days you people are using social media, fine. You see pictures of others, you see, okay, how successful she is, how happy he is. We start, you know, judging others by seeing the pictures. If any person has achieved success in life, it does not come for free. They have paid, fine, for this. And that payment which they have made, their hard work, their efforts, fine, n number of things are hidden behind their smile. We do not try to find that. We just see the success only. Success story, how that person reached to that level, that also we should try to find. So now in this, we will be reading. That's why in the first paragraph, they are saying that there is something disarming about Maria. Find something likable about her, very soothing personality. And she's a smiling girl, glamorous attire. And on 22nd August 2005, that was the day when she was ranked the number one. That rank keeps on changing. Even if you have reached to this level at once in lifetime, that is the biggest achievement. So on this particular date, underline, you need to remember, she was ranked top most position in women's tennis in that category. Clear? And within 4 years, the way that, you know, so now I asked you, we have to make comparison with Santosh Yadav also. Santosh also reached, within few years, she reached the zenith of success. Within 4 years, she also attained, she conquered Mount Everest, fine. So now you can see the picture of Sharapova when she won the women's singles at Wimbledon. Wimbledon is one of the prestigious competition of tennis. Every year it is there. And in 2004, she won the women's single at Wimbledon. Fine. So that is the picture. Can anyone name other tennis players? Who else who are ranked at the top most position except Maria Sharapova, if anybody can name. Yes, raise your hand. Yes, Titiksha, you raised hand. You want to speak?
Anna Mirza.
Sania Mirza or
ma'am, summit ka meaning bata do. SUMMIT.
That is the beta again, the topmost position. Okay, the top. Yes, we have Jatin with us. Yes, Jatin, the sports player of our class. Jatin, you can speak.
Rod Laver.
Yes.
Rod Laver, one of the best tennis players in the world.
Yes. What about Roger Federer? I was seeing. Then we have Djokovic also. Novak Djokovic, fine. So there are many, fine. Okay, Jatin, you can just down that, put your hand down. So I'm just saying there are many players, but yes, we are particularly talking about Maria Sharapova. That rank keeps on changing. Clear? They have different like singles, doubles, men single, men's double, women singles, women doubles. So there are categories of tennis. Okay, if you watch it, then you will know. Now, paragraph number two. However, the rapid ascent in a fiercely competitive world. Rapid here means fast, fine. And ascent. Ascent here means growth. Fine. Growth of a person or in any way. Clear? So, however, the rapid ascent in a fiercely competitive world. It means fiercely competitive means there is a lot of competition in this world. It began 9 years before with the level of sacrifice few children would be prepared to endure. Little Maria had not yet celebrated her 10th birthday when she was packed off to train in the United States. That trip to Florida with her father, Yuri, launched her on the path to success and stardom. But it also required a heart-wrenching 2 year separation from her mother, Yelena. Underline this. That was the question in the beginning. Name of the mother is Yelena. वाई से ही है, नेम ऑफ द फादर यूरी वाई से ही है. यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर द लेटर वॉज कंपेल्ड टू स्टे बैक इन साइबेरिया बिकॉज ऑफ वीजा रिस्ट्रिक्शंस. The 9-year old girl had already learnt an important lesson in life that tennis excellence would only come at a price. So, if you want to excel in anything, it does not mean you have to wait for 20 years ki main 20 saal ka ho jaun ya 30 saal ka ho jaun ya 25 ka. In that way, you have to start at early stages. When you are young, you are full of energy. You should have your goal in life if you want to go into the sports. So you can start early. Even these days, people are becoming aware. They start, even they make their children start at the age of 3 or 4 even. So when she was just, you know, his father was very particular that I want my girl to go into this game, in this sports. So when she was just 10-year-old, or you can say 9-year-old, and she just, his father took him to for further learning of the tennis, but at very young age, she learned a lesson of life. Her mother was, you know, when visa restrictions are there, there can be n number of restrictions. So her mother could not accompany her. So she was living in Siberia. It is written that she's born in Siberia. So she was born in Siberia, but she has to stay there. Her mother has to stay there, Yelena, because mother ko visa nahi mil. Fine, so that was the reason they went to Florida. Who went to Florida? Father and daughter. Okay, the duo, both of them, they went to Florida, and that was the beginning of the journey to learn. So at very young age, for that girl, it was very difficult to live without mother. 9-year-old is too young. Fine. So it was very difficult for her, but even then she lived. So she learned a very important lesson in life that to achieve something, you have to give a price, you have to lose something. She lost the touch of her mother for the training of tennis at the age of 9. Third paragraph. I used to be so lonely. Now, these are the words of Maria Sharapova. If you are successful, it does not mean you do not have emotions or you do not go through difficulties. She has mentioned, I used to be so lonely. Maria Sharapova recalls, I missed my mother terribly. My father was working as much as he could to keep my tennis training going. So he could not see me either. See, her father was busy in earning money, because when he will earn money, only then he can provide education to his daughter. So even he was not having that much time to see her daughter, see his daughter. So he was earning hard, working hard, and mother was not getting visa. So she has to, you can say, in a way, she was living alone only, getting training of tennis also, and anyhow managing at very young age. Because I was so young, I used to go to bed at 8 p.m. The other tennis pupils would come in at 11 p.m. and wake me up and order me to tidy up the room and clean it. You see that? So she was living in a very tough circumstance. At the age of 9, she was living alone from her parents just to get the training of tennis, and she would sleep at 8 p.m. And jab uske seniors aate the room mein, they would come at 11 p.m. and they would wake her up, that young girl, that get up, and they would order her to clean the room. So that was very difficult for a young girl whose parents are not with her to manage such thing all alone. And she was not able to get her sleep also. So paragraph number 5, instead of letting that depress me, I became more quietly determined and mentally tough. So two things are there in life, two things. One, when people torture you, you become negative, right? And second thing is, when people torture you, you become more stronger, you become more tough. So she was like that in second category. She became more determined and mentally tough. I learned how to take care of myself. I never thought of quitting because I knew what I wanted. She thought, if I will quit just because of this reason, they are torturing me or asking me to clean the room, if I will be quitting, that will be end of my learning. When you come from nothing, you have nothing. Am I audible now? There was some connection problem, so that's why. Right. Let me share the screen again. Can you see my screen better? Fine. So instead of letting that depress me, I became more quietly determined and mentally tough. And she learned how to take care of herself. I never thought of quitting. So she thought, if I will quit, you know, when you have nothing to lose, you become more stronger. So she was already living alone. And it makes her more hungry and determined. I would have put up, she was saying, my father is working harder. If I leave in between, this is the breaking the expectation of my parents also. So I would have put up with much more humiliation and insults than to steadfastly pursue my dream. So she thought I should not bother about getting humiliated and insulted by others. So that will go off and with passage of time, but I have to pursue my dream. Uska first priority kya tha? That is the priority list of your life that will decide your success. Fine. If topmost priority aapki ye rahegi ki usne mujhe tang kiya, he is bothering me, she is bothering me, you are not going to get success. You concentrate on, you know, wo yaad hai na, that Arjun ka, the fish, the target, the eyes on, in that way. Rest of the things we have to overlook when people are bothering you. You have to keep an eye on your goal. Right? So this is what she was doing. Clear? So instead of letting that depress means sadden, quitting means leaving, pursue means to follow. Easy words are there. I don't think so. There are some difficult words in this paragraph. Okay. So paragraph number 6, that toughness runs through Maria even today. So during, you can say, childhood, she faced a lot of difficulties. She became a very tough girl. It was the key to her bagging the women's singles crown at Wimbledon. What is the key of Maria to bag first position in singles? In 2004, already she suffered a lot. And to her meteoric rise to the world number one spot the following year. Now, meteoric here means, have you heard about meteor in your science? Have you heard? Now, why they have used this phrase meteoric rise here in this context means very fast movement. Fine. So they are comparing with that meteor. Okay. So it is very rapid growth. Itna usne toughness dekha life mein. She faced a lot of difficulties. You know, difficulties do not come to destroy you. Difficulties come to check how difficult you are. So Riyanshika, are you there? So you can, she is the, you know, taking the note of the attendance daily online. Okay. That's why I just confirmed. So that toughness made her more stronger and she reached the zenith in 2004 in Wimbledon. She got the topmost rank. Then after that, Vita, paragraph 7, while her journey from the frozen plains of Siberia, means it was quite in Siberia, you know, when you have other options where you can rise, you have to move there. So she had to move from Siberia. They have mentioned clearly that from that frozen plains of Siberia to the summit of women's tennis, to the top of women's tennis, has touched the hearts of tennis fans. For the youngster herself, there appears to be no room for sentiment. The straight looks and the answer she gives when asked about her ambition make it amply clear, purely clear, that she considers the sacrifices were worth it. I'm very, very competitive. I work hard at what I do. It's my job. This is her mantra for success. Underline, what is the mantra for success? According to Maria Sharapova, this is the answer underlined. right? So she has mentioned that whatever I do, I'm competitive, I put in hard work. She was very clear, her vision was clear. She was not having any dubious thoughts. She was not having any vague or unclear thoughts about her. Uska funda clear tha that what I want, I have to put in efforts, I have to put in a lot of hard work, only then I can achieve success. So she was very clear how to achieve success. Though Maria Sharapova speaks with a pronounced American accent. Accent is a particular country, how the way you speak. Fine. Every language has its own accent. So American accent, though she was born in Siberia, but at very young age, she shifted there. So she went to Florida. She went to many other places. So her accent was American accent, but she proudly parades her Russian nationality. Proudly parades here means that she is proud of being Russian. She never said, okay, I shifted to America to play tennis and I'm American now. But she was always proud of, you should not forget your roots. She never forgot. She was a Russian girl. So parades here means displays. Okay? It means displays. She proudly displays her Russian nationality, that yes, I belong to Russia, I'm proud of it. Clearing all doubts, she says, I am Russian. Underline, it's true that the US is a big part of my life, but I have Russian citizenship. My blood is totally Russian. I will play the Olympics for Russia if they want me. So I will represent Russia also if they want me. So because she was residing in USA, she represented USA many a times. Fine. So, but it doesn't mean that she forgot her nationality. Clear? Then, like any number of teenaged sensations, Maria Sharapova lists, underline beta, this is very important. So, you know, when you are a teenage, what do you like mostly, girls? Ki kya hobbies hoti hai? If I ask many of you, so you will answer me, ma'am, I like dancing, ma'am, I like singing, ma'am, I like fashion designing, I want to buy new dresses, I like doing makeup. Fine. So these are the basic things. She's also a girl who she lists. When you ask her, she will say fashion, singing and dancing as her hobbies. So these are the hobbies of Maria Sharapova: singing, dancing and fashion, means taking care of the latest fads and fashions. She loves reading novels of Arthur Conan Doyle. Who is Arthur Conan Doyle? Anybody can tell me? If you read detective novels, you definitely know who Arthur Conan Doyle is. Aaj iske baare mein search karna, this is your homework. You should know. Underline this name. Very prominent name in the form of, in the, you can say, zone of detective novels, and bahut interesting detective novels likhe hain Arthur Conan Doyle ne, in which you keep on reading and reading. Okay, what next? What next? You get so many interests. So she has mentioned that she is fan of Arthur Conan Doyle. Everything you should know. In the class only I am going to ask you. Her fondness for sophisticated evening gowns appears at odds with her love of pancakes with chocolate spread and fizzy orange drinks. When you go out to eat desserts and all, you love chocolavas, you love, you know, we love chocolate spread, and Gia wants to eat it. Your face is like that. Just a sochne lagi is a bad kid. So it's like she has mentioned that I'm just like an ordinary girl. I also like to dress up. I also like to wear gowns, and but it is at odds, means opposite. Why? Because on one side, she has to remain fit. Sports people have to be fit by all means. They are not allowed to eat desserts like us. They take care of their bodies, mental strength as well. Fine. So this is at odds. Isliye likha unhone that on one side she loves to wear dresses and she's very particular about her physique and all. On the other hand, this is at odds that she loves to eat pancakes also with chocolate spread and orange drinks also, which is not allowed to her. But even then, she enjoys once in a while. So Maria Sharapova cannot be pigeonholed or categorized. Now, pigeonholed ka meaning likho yahan pe, classified. classified. What do you mean pigeon holes? Have you seen in your staff room, we have pigeon holes. Pigeon hole is a kind of almira in which different holes, or you can say different compartments are given. Fine, boxes are given and chits are written. Okay, you can in your home also, you might be having cupboards in which in one cupboard you are having shoes, on the other cupboard you are having clothes, in the third you are having accessories. So you have labeled that, you have classified that. So they are saying Maria Sharapova cannot be pigeonholed or categorized. You cannot categorize her. Her talent, unwavering desire, unmovable, which cannot be shaken, that is unwavering. Desire to succeed and readiness to sacrifice have lifted her to the top of the world. So number one, she has talent. Number two, she knows how to put in efforts and how to do hard work. And thirdly, she is ready to sacrifice. If you want to achieve success, usne bachpan se, you remember, she sacrificed the love of the mother for so many years. She lived, mother was in Florida, mother was in Siberia, she was in Florida, she was sobbing sometimes, she was crying without parents, father was busy, even then she sacrificed and then she achieved something. So few would grudge, few would grudge her riches she is now reaping. So I told you, when we look at others, we say, okay, how successful he is, how successful she is, rather than thinking that how that person has reached to that position. So they are saying many people are jealous of her riches, but she's now reaping. Reaping means after when you sow a seed, you put in efforts, and one day definitely if you have put in efforts, you will get the fruits of the tree also. So now this is the high time she has put in efforts in the young age, and now when she is an adult, she is in the middle age right now. So she is getting a lot of fruits out of that seeds which she sown as she was a child. This is what she has to say about her monetary gains from tennis. You know that very, you can say, costly game or sports it is considered. Tennis is, you know, there was a time when tennis was considered a game for rich people only, a sports of rich people. Why? Because a lot of monetary things you have to, you know, invest to buy the tennis, to buy the tennis balls, to attire, then get the club membership to learn and training. It's very costly. So this is what she has to say about her monetary gains from tennis. Of course, money is a motivation. You know, there are some people, they say, okay, mujhe to paise nahi chahiye, just want to achieve success, people. This is wrong. Money is required in life. If you get more money, you get motivated. But everybody do not accept it. She is accepting it humbly. She's saying, yes, money is a big motivation, because when you win a game in tennis, you get huge amount of money as compared to other sports. So tennis is a business and a sport. Underline this. She has clearly mentioned that it is not like that I am playing a sport. Yes, it is a business also. And the most important thing is to become number one in the world. That's the dream that kept me going. So she's saying, above all, money is important, sports is important, my interest for the game is also important. But above all, when I'm ranked number one in the world, that feeling is beyond comparison. That's the dream that kept me going. Clear? So she has clearly mentioned that. Okay, beta. So we are not left with time. So second period was till 9:50 a.m. only. And on my laptop, it's 9:49. So we have 1 minute. You can ask if any doubt is there regarding anything. Fine. What is your work now? Tomorrow is a holiday. Your task is to solve the exercises of part two. Part one was already discussed in the class with all your participation. Now, this is thinking about the language. Everything you will solve on the book only, but only question answers that we will discuss. But you have to firstly find the answers. You will give me the answers and then this is also whatever skills are mentioned. Okay, I'm just showing you the exercises so that you can do. Fine. So we are done with this.